All right, let's get this going. Let's get this going. Welcome back, everyone. There we go. So, yeah, the timer was not down, but let's just get cracking. So, we are still in Cubase. Quick little template, in case you're wondering, links down below in the description. That's available if you want to work with that. Anyway, Ember, yeah, it's been a while, it's true that. But yeah, I definitely want to write something with this thing. This is nothing short of amazing new library. So there we go. Okay. The question is, with all that stuff going on here, where to start? And I may start with some synth, Atmo. Soundscapes. There we go. Let's try some of the soundscapes and see. How many sounds do we have here? There's quite a bunch of stuff going on. Full range, partial range. Let's try the tonal ones. Just using the high pass to get rid of some of the low end. And in the performance page, let's try to use the gate a little bit. Just want to use this as a starting point, just to don't even know the tempo yet. Although the synth sounded good, so let's go with that. Okay, let's start with that. Okay, let's go with these 8 bars for the intro. A little bit of mod wheel movement there. Let's start very low. There we go. Okay. Okay, we need a sub boom, something like that. So it's likely gonna be damage. Damage, yeah. Ensemble designer, and let's see if we find something for the low end. Factory. Do hybrid hits, damage hits, man. Hybrid sub palette. That one. Maybe even put the filter on it. The other way around, low pass, pass, yeah, Yeah, take that as a boom. Okay, on the second part here, let's put a little ARP thingy below that. Let's see if we can find something. Let's check the loop combos. That one's pretty cool. Okay, let's take this. A little bit of mod wheel. Wasn't totally in time, but that's fine. Just gonna have this running through. All right. I use a little bit of gravity for some whooshes. Gravity. Whooshes menu. There we go. Or maybe interesting to stick to damage 2 and symphonic design, symphonic destruction. So that means we can go with the ensemble designer and use the hybrid whooshes. I think these are timed. Yeah, that's a full bar. Okay, now just to find the sound. Oh, by the way, it also says 4-beat up here. I like that one. Very simple. So let's put this down. Okay, another ARP. I do have Saga. So yeah, we could use that. Let's see. I want to go with a designer and start with an empty patch. All macros off. And let's just use one sound here. Okay, that one is pretty cool. And let's go to the cycle. This is channel one. Sixteen steps is fine. Randomize that a little. Okay, let's tweak macro a little. I want to So let's give it a little drive, the chorus of the track. I just want to change the cycle a little, just randomize that a little more, and I don't like the distortion. I want to change that. Drive. Let's go with saturation. getting there. Okay, let's see how that sounds. Hey, Tinubio, you're welcome. Okay, let's try this. So, not much needed in terms of mod wheel data, just straight through. I think we can turn these up a little. And give them a little reverb and delay. Let's add some signal sounds there from the RAM designer. Let's go with all tails. We are in D. Oh, that one is cool. I like the pitch shifting there. And just an interesting sound. Let's push that a little. Punish, and I want to add the gate, turn that down and put it on mod wheel. No, can I not put the gate on the mod wheel? Oh, I can through the macro control. But I am on channel 2. Just a little bit of smoothing. Yeah, so mod wheel adds a little bit of movement. Okay. Turn that down a little. Volume, and let's add the delay. And also let's do the panning a little. We start on the left, and with the mode we're going up, let's move it a little to the right. See how that sounds. And last but not least, let's add a little drive. Like that. That's pretty cool. We can also add in, let's see, some of these damage patches have some nice ambient type of stuff. Didn't someone mention the clock ticks? Yeah, that's pretty cool. turn the compressor on this. Okay, let's take this one. We may automate the panning. I like that overall, but we need a little bit of reverb on this one and let's put Sound Toys Penman on that. Not full width, back and forth. Let's go with Rhythmic Step. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Like 2 bars. 5 steps. One bar. See how that sounds? Needs to go faster. Half note. Yeah, I like that. Very just turn the volume down a little. Okay, we need a build up here to see what we can use. Some riser type of stuff. Find something in damage. If not, we use gravity. But I think there's not really some riser stuff in damage. Not as far as I remember. Transitions, hybrid whooshes, long reverses and whooshes. That might be it. That one's pretty cool. Okay, let's take that. Okay, so the intro is kind of there. Okay, let's go to the performers, traditionals. Mm-hmm. Let's try the hybrid ones. I like the idea of limiting the velocity range. Doesn't sound like typical string sound, so just want to try that. Let's go with a typical 16th ostinato here. And what we could do to avoid playing the 16th, we could do two repeats each. Not as crescendo, but first. Yeah, it's way more easily playable. Maybe make it more dry. I like that. So let's put that in. So that means we only need to play eighth notes because we got the get the 16th automatically. We are actually in D. Then we can bring that all to the same volume. Nope. What's the difference in volume when we put it up? So since we changed the velocity range, it doesn't make that much of a difference in terms of sound and timbre, it just brings it up a little more. That a little forward. Oh, minus 60 is already. That's maybe not as much. Now I would layer that with some natural strings on top. Maybe some arc 4. See how that behaves. Okay, let's go with full throttle here. Yeah, let's put some arc underneath. This obviously needs to be in 16th now, because we don't have the auto playing. turning the second one a little down. We can keep that, just volume up a little, the second one. Repeat this, and just keep building. Now we can already bring in some soft Brahm face. Not you. Let's go with the Brahm designer. Let's start more classical. Hey Sergio, good to see you. Okay, just listen to what we have so far. Let's add, just for because we can, let's add some of the guitars. Obviously. I like that. I like that quite a bit, to be honest. They have a little too much low end for my taste. So let's go with a high pass again. And just cut them off below 70. Space, obviously needs delay. Filter again, a little more. You just don't want to have too much low end because we have so much going on already in the low end and the rumbling, so. To automate the volume a little bit on this one. So CC7 comes in at 60. So let's start at 60 and move that up to, say, 80. I think that's enough. Just want to have a little bit of dynamic development there in the guitar. It's coming in a little louder. Stuff the high end. Oh, nice, nice. We can add this second layer there. And duplicate this and just make it a little louder. Okay, let's put the sub again here, here. So that signal's a little loud here, so let's turn it down a bit. I'll chain that last bit there. So you've got a little bit of a dynamic curve there. Cheers, Josh. Okay. All right. Where are we in terms of time? 40 seconds in. A little two-bar break here, and then we bring on some beef. I want to add some more percussion. Nope, 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 yes. All right. I guess I need to tweak that later, but definitely the short time, the short release helps. I don't like the sound at all. Nope, that's not gonna be it. Okay, just need to find some rhythmic pattern that works underneath here. Kind of like this. Kept the first one free because I actually want to put a trailer hit there. Now it's not always good. Okay, let's take the first part. Okay, now for sure that the other two don't have any downers, so I want to use these from Gravity. Down. Yep, that's where we can start getting serious. Let's add some middle percussion. Thank you. That's great. It's a role and it's modware controllable. So we can put that very quietly underneath. That's pretty cool. Why Cubase over Studio One? Pretty much because Cubase was open. Simple answer. And then we go into the big part, kind of like climax or main section. That's what I would call it. So. Copying that, let's add some brass here. Let's support that Brahm a little bit. Like that, where this is going. Although I have no idea what the main part is probably gonna be like, but yeah, I need some badass Brahm stuff there. So let's start with that. In D, please, and don't kill my ears. Doesn't get bigger than that. Was more improvised than anything else, but this is so incredibly easy to work with. Okay, I may cheat a little and not use Aviosity on this, because I kind of hear that stuff that we recently reviewed with Groth. Awesome Devastator. That's too going too far away from where we started. Okay. Back to damage. Oh, close. What did I do? Yeah. Okay. Classic Cubase crash. That is new. And I haven't saved in a while, I guess. Freaking hell. Ah, damn it. That hasn't happened in a while. Let's see. Nope, not there. So... Well, at least we have the latest save at 1:40, 2 minutes ago. Yeah, same folder, please. I should have saved that. This happens. You start to write a track and you don't even give it a name and save it. Should be up in a second. And yes, I got it all the stream on YouTube, so I can recreate it. That's true. Come on. Or maybe that's a sign to call it a day for tonight and just keep working on that tomorrow in a night session. I actually like where this track is going. So, and yeah, Scamot, you're right. It has some feel, a little bit of TV heavy tension kind of stuff. Hang out here to hear what we create. Well, let's see. So, where were we? Yes, I think we have a winner. Okay, actually, let's save this thing. Save as. I like that. It's funny, I kind of miss the automation features from the macro that Symphonic Destruction has. Would love to mangle a little more on damage too with these type of macros that they have for the other one. Okay, copy the ticking. The only thing that I'm actually gonna use from other stuff is the hits. So for the hits, we are going to either Devastator or, yeah, I think Devastator. Yeah, that one's pretty nice. Okay, let's see. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. By the way, that's my technique to kind of find out which hit lands on the one. I just play a few of these. See if that one sounds good. And that sounds like pretty precise on the one. Yeah, I'm sorry that the time didn't follow my move. Nah, too melodic. Like that. Let's see how it sounds with the rhythm. Follow the loop rhythm a little bit. Diddle 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 diddle. Okay, let's try that. No, that was wrong. Once more. I like the major there from the D. It's kind of interesting. Yeah, let's copy that to the strings. The only external instrument we used, triples arc. that's great that you can adjust the Brahms to the whatever key you want to play. That's pretty cool. Okay, let's record that again. Another save, there you go. Sorry, I gotta listen to the full thing for a moment. So I want to see what it sounds like when we go to D here, to D major. Interesting combination with a C on top there with a 7. Tinuvial, that one is probably going to be on my YouTube channel, just in the regular stream schedule or in the live sessions. Okay, we need something more pad-like on top there. There were some great instruments that we checked earlier in the designer. CPU is going crazy right now. Okay, no, there we go. That's better. Thank you. kind of like... Let's try that dive bomb down. That obviously needs to be way quieter in the background, just giving a little bit of a hint that something's going on there. Hard to quantize this one. I just want to see what the percussion section so far sounds on its own. Ah, that was a little loud. And we need some cymbals. Thanks, Nikki. Appreciate it. Still working on it. That dive down synth is pretty insane. I do like that a lot. Thanks, Ragnar. Yeah, kind of like, I feel like I'm gonna call it a day in a little bit. It's like, right around 2 a.m. here. Let me duplicate the guitar. Bring out the ball. I want to keep the safe. I want to keep the settings with a filter. Okay, let's record these. Add more volume on these. Okay, gonna save. Give it one last listen through, but I think this is worth keep working on. I like the direction a lot, where this is heading. Yeah, for the moment, let's stop here. That's definitely going to be another night session to keep going with that. Again, holy hell, mostly symphonic destruction and a little bit of damage, a little bit of extra strings. That's it. The brass sounds insane. Just the low end here. Well, that track turns out well. It's likely going to end up in our own catalog. So, but yeah, no idea yet. We'll see how this goes. So yeah, let's call it a night. Thanks so much for staying with me and trying to write something with this beautiful, beautiful new library. Definitely a good start for a track and something we can keep working on. And see you next time. Thanks so much for tuning in and see you soon. Bye-bye.